All right. Welcome everyone to the movie tonight. Just to let you know, the movie runtime on this is 115 minutes. So if you have to get up and leave and for whatever, you know, it's not a problem to me. You can always watch it again. I believe, and I don't know this, I believe that it is the church's DVD. So you may actually be able to borrow it from the church to finish watching. Or I think that we're going to show, I think on that card you'll see that there's the website, vom.org. You take it to there, and there may be a code or a link on that to actually watch the movie there. So, but anyway, that's just so that you know that it's going to be like an hour or 115 minutes. So, all right, let's go ahead and get started. We're going to open with prayer. Come on in. Hey, I know them. I know these people. How are you? There you go. I'll give you one of them, and you can give one to your sister. You can sit anywhere you like. This church does not have assigned pews where I don't, you know, at least I don't think they do. Maybe. Well, there's another one. Hey, I know her too. She don't wave at me though. You don't wave at me though. I know you, but you don't wave at me. I seen you in Marysville turning on to 850. So, yeah, you're concentrating. Hey, no problem in concentrating on the road. We don't want no accidents. So, all right, let's go ahead and start with prayer, and then we'll get the movie started so we can get her going. All right. Father God, we thank and praise you for this day, Lord. We thank you that you've given us your Son to be our Lord and Savior, to redeem us. Lord, without him, we would have no hope. He is the only hope that we have, and he is the only redemption, the only true way to have a relationship with you. And Lord, we just thank you for him. We thank you that you sent him to be our Redeemer. And Lord, as we watch this movie tonight, let us understand that we need to, as Christians, we need to be out there just spreading your love to everyone we meet, whether we like them or don't like them. You love everyone. So our job is to share your love with everyone we come in contact with. And we'll thank and praise you for everything that is done to further your kingdom and to bring you glory. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. Go ahead, Scott. Give that a shot. I'll catch the lights. I think all you have to do is hit the start button. I had one more thing I forgot to mention. I believe it's on the card. I was telling the folks that you can go to vom.org, and that brings up their website. You can if you want to donate to Voice of the Martyrs, that is the place to do it. So with that, we're going to go ahead and play the movie.
Thank you. du eure Waffen nieder. Gut, dass wir auf dich
hören. Halt's Maul!
Aber du hast gesagt...
Ich weiß, was ich gesagt habe. Du lebst noch, oder? Jetzt müssen wir abhauen.
Von einer Familie gehört, die uns vielleicht hilft.
Wie hilft?
Unterschlupf. Vielleicht etwas zu essen. Hier lang, denke ich. Sind Sie Sabina von Bald? Ich habe gehört, dass Sie uns vielleicht helfen wollen.
Come into our house all the time. You can't stay there.
And how do you know we can trust you?
I don't.
You know it's a death sentence if you shelter a German soldier.
I know.
When the Reich recaptures Bucharest, which we'll surely do, I'll never do for you what you are doing for us.
I will protect you from the Russians. I can't protect you from the wrath of God.
Why? Why would you risk your life for a German soldier?
My name is Sabina Wurmbrand. I am a pastor's wife. And that is the very, very last thing I ever thought I would be. I once was Sabina Oster. Bincha, they called me.
The entire college syllabus? The whole thing?
Of course. I study everything the boys study.
Not physics. You don't study physics.
Uncle Jacob. Yes, physics, math, and chemistry.
Well, good for you. I'm proud of you.
Why shouldn't I? Sorbonne isn't known for pioneering so much as for Marie.
Marie?
Madame Marie Curie, Nobel Prize winner.
She's from Sabine.
Oh, Uncle, you should get out more.
You should visit Paris. I could show you everything.
Do you wish to be Marie Curie?
Of course not. I want her to wish to be me.
If at all.
I want the same things every girl wants. And then a little bit more.
I have to make a stop. Mm. I want you to meet someone.
Oh.
He's every bit as ambitious as you.
Oh. But first, I want to drive your car.
What?
Yes.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
It's impossible.
Please.
I said no, 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 no. Jacob, what are you doing here?
May we come up?
Yeah, of course. Who's this?
She is my niece, Sabina Oster. Sabina, this is Richard Fulmrod, a rising star at the Brookridge.
The first time I ever laid eyes on Richard Wurmbrand, I was not impressed. He appeared to me brooding, entitled, and pampered.
You let her drive your car?
Didn't really have much of a choice.
I'm terribly sorry for my countenance. I thought you were someone else.
Who did you think I was?
Well, it's my mother.
Oh, you thought I was your mother?
No. Of course not. But my mother is nagging me to get married. She's even picked out a girl.
Oh, she picked the girl. How thoughtful of her.
She selected an heiress, actually. Comes with a business. Two homes and $1 million in dowry.
That sounds very nice for you.
It does. I mean, it would. I have no problem with the business part or the inheritance. It's the girl I don't like. My mother thinks this is the quickest way for us all to be rich.
And what do you think?
What do I think? Mm-hmm. I think my mother should ask me that question. Oh.
It's not that I was desperate for love. In fact, I'd been dating a boy at Sorbonne. I had not told my family about my love life at school. So far as they knew, I was still living the life of straight-laced moral purity as imposed on me by my parents. If they only knew. So, tell me about your heiress.
My mother's heiress, you mean?
Well, you're to be married. And all that money.
The thought occurs to me that if I could find a girl like you, I wouldn't care about the cash.
Never underestimate the cash.
I'm going to go for a walk. Your mother's gonna kill me.
saved your space.
No,
you're not going to just sit there tonight.
Fine. We will dance, and you can drink.
With Richard, I saw a path to realize everything I'd dreamed of in life. He was handsome, he made great money, and he spent plenty of that money on me. Your steps are a bit blurry.
So is my vision. Person, you know?
This is so boring.
You'd suffer a lot with me.
And laugh a lot.
So you'll have me then.
I knew then and there, Sorbonne would have to wait.
With this cup, I make a covenant with you.
You are now man and wife.
Thank you, Father.
Oh, first one kiss, first one married.
Well, first one married anyway.
So. Congratulations, Richard. You've officially taken the plunge.
And so religious. Does the rabbi even know you're atheist?
Never said a word about it.
So, your mother's happy.
I think she's still holding out for the rich girl. She'll always blame you, you know.
Really? In this case, may I have a glass? A big one.
Did you really think you could hide from me all day long?
I wasn't hiding.
Well, good, because I want a hug from you. That's not a good enough hug. I want a real hug.
Mom, fine. Big hug.
A big hug.
You know, there's cake.
Have we pleased them all?
My parents got their rabbi, my sisters got their music, and my brother got his cake. What more could they want?
Well, I want another drink.
In those days, we cared little about God, nor very much about other people. We didn't want children. We wanted pleasure.
What does this have to do with us?
Everything. Without Richard in my life, you certainly wouldn't be.
We don't need your love stories. We need a way out of here.
Let her talk. Were you happy? Was the marriage a happy one?
We were happy. At least we thought we were.
Enough, or should I walk you home from here? I'd accept if you could walk straight.
Well, if you ever...
Don't go. Drive safe, you know.
A year into our marriage, Richard started coughing. My goodness, are you gagging?
Not gagging, it's just a little tickle. What are you doing?
Calling the doctor.
I don't need a doctor, I'm fine. I'll rest a couple of days.
Want us a chili, please? TB was common in those days. Very often it was lethal. Richard was diagnosed and sent to a sanatorium in the mountains. With total rest, fresh air, and lots of sunshine, he had a chance. The doctor said 50-50. Are you ready for this?
Well, are you ready?
For you to die? No.
Are you ready to stay with your mother? You may have the harder ordeal.
It's not funny. You're not funny.
You'll survive.
I'll visit as soon as I can get a day off work. Don't forget about me.
I'll try not to.
Thank you.
marriages.
Thank you.
Yes, I'm Richard von Brandt.
You look worse than my last patient.
Well, I'm...
Stop it! Do not cough on me. Not near me. Never when I'm in this room. What is this?
A book? Matty gave it to me.
No reading. I told you once already. Only rest. I set the lights out.
Place to such a round trip same day.
Mr. Wurbrandt, you have a visitor.
Send him away. I am far too busy for visitors today. You are overdressed. Marie, did you not send my wife the dress code here? You look like an angel.
And you look like an Olympian. Oh, I brought you this. I thought it would either help you think or help you sleep.
You're not supposed to be reading. You're to be resting.
It's okay, Marie. This is Marx. And his theories are the opium of the people.
What theories?
Well, Marx says the abolition of religion is the requisite for real happiness.
Well then, That means we should be quite happy.
Mark's never found happiness. I'm not sure he's the one to listen to.
How are you feeling? Have you been resting?
I feel that for the first time in my life, I'm resting.
Are you terribly bored?
I've been thinking.
About what?
About my life. About all the people I've harmed. My mother and many girls you don't even know about.
Don't worry about it. I've also lived such a life. This is youth. And when we get home, we'll have fun again.
Maybe.
Darling, you have to be, not mental illness. We are going to be fine.
I've been thinking again about you.
Children?
Richard, you should lie down.
I'm sorry.
If we had children, how would we raise them? What morals would we teach them? What morals do we have for our own lives? Take this with you. Look at it on the train.
The Brothers Ratisbon? A Christian book. Why are you reading this, Richard? I will not read this lies.
I may not survive this illness. It's 50-50. But if I do, I don't want to waste my life. Our life. Not any longer, not one day.
Waste? We are not wasting our lives, Richard. I don't know what to even say to you.
Say you love me and that you'll be back in 2 weeks.
That book. My father used to read it.
That book is banned, you know?
Have you read it?
Of course not. It's banned.
Finally, when winter returned, Richard began to get some of his strength back, and they let him out for short walks.
Hello, Nikolai. You are dead, and so shall be I. The snow will fall on us both while the living carry on. I shall not exist. After a while, nobody will remember us. What is the use, Nikolai? What is the point of any of this?
Richard was still convinced that there was no God, but had begun wishing it was otherwise. He wanted there to be a reason for existing.
God? I'm certain you don't exist, but if you do, it's your job to reveal yourself to me.
Hey!
Salutare!
Ai fost la biserică?
Mă tem că nu.
De unde ești?
Din București, dar sunt internat la sanatoriu.
Ești evreu?
Născut, nu practicant.
Cum te cheamă?
Richard. Richard Umbran.
E bine, eu mă numesc Christian Wolfkes. Și vreau să-ți dau asta, ție. Eu și soția mea ne-am rugat pentru tine. Și am vrea să primești asta.
Cum adică v-ați rugat pentru mine?
Aici ară ai ocazia să vorbești cu cineva despre Iisus Hristos.
Serios?
Așa că m-am rugat la Dumnezeu să-mi trimite un evreu. Și iată-te.
Iată-mă. Dar nu mă tem că ați venit prea târziu.
Niciodată nu este prea târziu. Să nu subestimezi niciodată puterea rugăciunii.
Să spuneți asta și prietenului meu, Nicolae.
So, your husband got sick and began talking to dead people. Is there a point in all this?
My country was getting sick too, right at the same time. The legionnaires promised a fascist utopia. Their leader was Corneliu Codreanu. He went from village to village, making Hitler proud.
Look, a horse!
I know that man. Go home! You don't speak for Romania.
I love that horse.
Eu sunt Corneliu Zelea Codreanu. Vă salut din partea legionarilor și a gărzii de fier. A venit vremea pentru un nou spirit în România. Dar mai înainte, trebuie să ne curățăm de dușmanul din sânul țării noastre. Și cine este acest dușman? Evreii! O știm cu toții. Un flagel fără egal pe pământul ăsta. O rasă care nu produce nimic pentru țară. Cu minte bolnavă. Ahtiată după înavuțire proprie.
Ar trebui să mergem.
Ne-au scurs țara de identitate națională. Ne-au îmbolnăvit copiii. A venit vremea să legăm alianțe noi, cu prieteni noi, puternici, cu Hitler și Mussolini. Cu asemenea aliați, nu avem cum să ne temem de dușmanii noștri. Așadar, totul pentru patrie!
By our blood, we cement the future of legendary Romania. Each of you must be ready to both give and embrace death. The Archangel Michael comes not with a sickle, but with a sword!
Have we lost our minds?
Calm down.
Ready to give and embrace death? This is crazy.
If you're not with us, you're against us.
If you are ready!
Let him go. There is no victory without bloodshed.
Come on, Richard. You've been here plenty long enough.
Coming.
You know, I'm going to miss you. Truly.
Richard, time to go.
Oh, I'll go fetch your release papers. It should only take a few minutes.
Come on, walk with me down to the pond.
Won't be long, she says. It has already been. Very
good
time.
Yes, it has. But also a good time. Time to think. Time to consider Jesus.
Don't say that name. I remember hearing of Jews who chose to murder their children and commit suicide to avoid converting to Christianity.
That doesn't enhance my respect for those Jews.
Richard, I was mocked when I was a girl. Dirty little Jews, they shouted at me. That is Christianity. We want nothing to do with it.
If that is Christianity, nobody should want anything to do with it. I've been comparing Jesus' life with mine.
There's nothing to compare.
His outlook was so pure, and mine so tainted.
Your outlook is fine.
His nature so selfless, mine so greedy.
Richard, you are starting to sound like a convert.
I have long been an atheist, my love. But a universe with no creator cannot compare to the thought of a God who speaks and listens. The demands of Christianity are too extreme. They are impossible to fulfill. The Bible says that he who says he's Christ must also live as Jesus lived. But is that possible? It's like asking a wolf to live like a lamb and then condemning it for all eternity for not succeeding. Since I have not been Christ through all eternity, I was not born of a virgin. Since I have no clear perception of spiritual realities, nor do I have his mind, how should I be able to live as he did?
Only a very proud person could imagine himself capable of living like Jesus. The commandment to live like Jesus, like all the commandments in the Bible, It reveals to us the depth of our sinfulness, our deep need for a savior.
No, Isaac, no. I do not want a Jesus who has been calculated, explained, and believed in. I want a real Jesus. Is that such an impossible ideal?
Richard! You're a smart guy. Smarter than me. I cannot talk you into faith. Come tonight. Come to the prayer meeting. See if the real Jesus reveals himself to you. So then, who can find God? Anyone who seeks him. Jesus taught his disciples that everyone who asks receives, and he that seeks finds. To him that knocks, the door shall be opened. Who can find God? Everyone can. That's God's promise. Everyone, no exceptions. Let's pray on that.
Richard said he was involuntarily lifted up by the Spirit, astonished to hear himself praying aloud at a public gathering. Words, he said, that sprang from the depths of his soul. Have you been? Your dinner is cold.
I've done it. I have surrendered my heart to Christ. And it's a beautiful thing. And now, all that's left to do is to be baptized.
In baptism, baptism, we renounce our sin. We proclaim our belief in God and commit ourselves to Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Richard, is this your own proclamation?
Yes, truly, with all my heart.
If Richard was going to make a horrible decision, so would I.
Richard Wurmbrand, I baptize you in the name of the Father.
If we couldn't have the life I wanted,
and of the Son,
then we wouldn't have life at all.
And of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And when Richard found my body, he would realize how destructive this faith of his was.
Obviously, you didn't kill yourself.
Obviously. But then I had a thought.
What if he's right? What if there is a God? Or worse, a hell? Or what if he went out, found a new wife, and forgot all about me? Help me understand.
What are you reading?
If your enemy is hungry, give him bread to eat. If he's thirsty, give him water to drink. That's ridiculous.
The heart of the gospel is forgiveness. For us to forgive others in the same way God has forgiven us. Is that so bad?
Waste of time, these movies.
This time we recognize that there is a plague here, a plague that threatens the health of the Aryan peoples.
Thank you, darling.
For what?
For this. We're skipping church for once. We're gone with the wind. And men?
Gambling with souls, too, please. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now I have a soft spot in my heart for attractive girls like you in distress. I have more money than I know what to do with. Now how better could I spend it than by making you happy? Would $1,000 help you?
Oh, it's certainly woman.
I always loved movies.
I have considerable cash in my apartment.
But I never calculated the moral influence they had over me.
That's the story. You care to stop by for a few minutes on the way home? I expect you have the money tonight.
The Nazi propaganda films were surely filled with lies. But nobody seemed to question their statistics.
In 1932, the Jews, who only made up 1% of the world's population, accounted for 34% of the world's dope peddlers, 47% of robberies, 47% of crooked games of chance, 82% of international crime organizations, and 98% of dealers in prostitution.
The Hollywood movies I loved were filled with lies of a different kind. Nobody questioned them either. Nobody except my husband.
So, did you like it?
Of course.
Me too.
Now, to go home and go to bed. I want to find that girl to take to the hotel.
What did you say?
It's pretty simple. You go home. I think I want to find that girl to take to the hotel.
Richard, how can you even say that?
But you made me go to the movie, and you saw what the hero did. Why shouldn't I do the same thing? And if we go tomorrow and the next day to movies like those, I'm just making a point. Every man becomes what he looks at. If you want me to be a good husband, come to church with me sometimes.
Sorry? I wasn't aware we were meeting.
No, you weren't.
And you are?
Cornelius de la Quadrano. Legionnaires. Perhaps you've heard of us?
I'm sorry, Jacob. We're making a move. Could that be avoided?
A move?
What are you talking about?
We've agreed to a merger.
With the Germans?
I'm Romanian. Actually. And the new director. We've had a slight change in executive policy.
Jacob, we had no choice.
No Jews.
What?
It's not complicated, is it? No Jews. Leave now, and we won't follow you home.
Just like that?
You can. We can make this very personal. Have you seen the work of the Iron Guard?
The Iron Guard, as the Legionnaires were called, were taking over Romania. They were conscripting members, taking businesses, and terrorizing Jews.
Mulțumesc. Domnule? Iar mașina asta. E cea mai bună pe care o avem, domnule. Ne trebuie blindată.
Da, domnule prim-ministru.
Să mergem.
One Sunday evening, we were invited to attend a big party. I begged Richard to let us go.
At least pretend to have fun, Richard. We haven't seen Andrei and Alexandra for ages.
Excuse me.
such a nice imagination in that.
Surprise.
Take this, darling. Take. Okay. Come, come, come.
So, I didn't expect you to show up tonight. This isn't exactly church.
Oh. Here it is. Come on.
I propose a toast.
And one for you.
To friends.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. To the future.
We shouldn't stay too long.
Relax, you've just gotten here. It would be rude to leave so soon.
Află mult dorita ușurare a suferințelor prin sirop. Inverbes, scutit legal, preparat, încercat de mult.
Ridică-te, hai! Tu, vino aici! Hai, hai, hai! Punem în direct! Atențiune, România! Prim-ministrul Armand Călinescu este mort! Executat pentru binele națiunii!
și în beneficiul tuturor românilor. Trăiască gardă de fier! Hai, Hitler!
Do not be afraid, for I am with you. Genesis 26. Do not be afraid or discouraged. Deuteronomy 1. Do not be afraid of them. Joshua 8.
I'm kind of afraid.
I'm collecting all the verses in the Bible that tell us not to be afraid. I think I might need to lean on all of them.
Read me some more.
Are not two sparrows sold for a farthing? And one of them shall not fall on the ground without your father. But the very hairs of your head are numbered. Fear ye not, therefore, ye are of more value than many sparrows. If they are coming, then they're coming. Let's not think of them as enemies to be feared, but rather as a mission.
Komm schon! Halt!
They are asking to see IDs.
Christian, really?
So, schon ein Wetter für Spaziergang, oder?
Will be the end of our life together. I'll be tortured, perhaps killed.
Whosoever will save his life shall lose it, and whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. We believe this, or we don't. I think we have to stay. We have a job to do.
Stop!
Aber wo da?
Jetzt schon? Das hast du schon recht, weil der wird das Gipfel. Mit dem Hund zusammen, oder was?
Ja. Also, ganz schön gut.
By 1940, we had a new baby, Mihai. And a new prime minister, Major Ion Antonescu. Under him, new waves of persecution were unleashed on the Jews. We set out to meet our neighbors, to try to make new friends.
Just across the street, I'm Richard von Brandt. This is my wife, Sabina, and our baby, Mihai.
Are you selling something or what?
No, we're just out to get to know people. We brought you this.
Relations in our new neighborhood were tense at first. But people often warmed up when we actually met them face to face. When we showed them some kindness.
What?
My name is Richard von Brandt. This is my wife Sabina and our baby Mihai. We are your neighbors just across the street.
Jewish?
Well, Christian now.
How convenient.
You don't like Jewish people?
They're users. They take, but they don't contribute. No, I don't like Jewish people.
That's a nice sewing machine. What make is it? Ah, it's a Singer. Hold on. Wasn't that invented by a Jew? I guess if you think the Jews are so useless, you'd better get rid of it.
What do you want? You want to do my sewing?
Just to say hello and...
We brought you some jam.
Don't tell me a Jew invented jam.
I don't know, but it's good whoever invented it. Don't you like jam?
I love jam. Yeah, thank you. I'm sorry I smashed it the last time I was arguing with Anna. And Anna, come on here and meet our neighbors.
Yeah. Is he a daughter?
I hope so. She looks like me.
Hey, you got the jam too? Huh?
And then Richard became a pastor, Lutheran. We devoted our lives to loving people. We made many new friends, shared Christ with everyone, and found much happiness. But outside, all hell was raging. In 1940, Romania formally announced that its foreign policy was now to be determined by Hitler's new European order. Within a year, over one-third of Romania's Jewish population were massacred. In the northern city of Iași, 11,000 Jews were killed in one day. We heard of seven girls who had survived the massacre up in Iași. We were trying to get them to safety.
Parte știu că ascunzi evrei aici.
Puteți să vă uitați, dar nu e niciun evreu aici. Asta e o mănăstire creștină.
Thank you.
Jews were not permitted to travel anywhere in Romania. And Iași is hundreds of miles from Bucharest. But we had a plan. To have the girls arrested by our friends in the Romanian police, then transported to the capital for trial, before which they would mysteriously disappear.
Be sure they don't miss their train.
I'll do my best.
We found waves wherever we could to shelter the innocent. But so many people refused to get involved, allowing thousands who might have been saved to perish.
Un ceas, vă rog. Un ceas. Nu știu dacă am întârziat pentru trenul de ora 11 și dacă e
10 jumate.
Involvement, however, came with a price.
Thank you.
N-am înțeles.
10 jumate. Bine,
10 jumate. Aș putea să văd eu, vă rog. Pot să văd? Ah, ok. Mulțumesc. Mulțumesc, yeah. Mulțumesc mult.
Ia.
Yeah. Uite un foc.
Sind Sie Sabina von Bran?
One morning I was arrested. I didn't know at that moment that Richard had been taken as well. I wondered, were they going to shoot me? Was I to die without warning in the darkness?
Ia și scrie. Nume? Numele ăsta cu care lucrezi, da? Scrie.
Vă rog, am un copil.
Scrie niște nume și poți să mergi acasă.
They wanted me to write something that could be used against Richard. So I wrote.
Engleză? Știi să citești?
Da, să trăiți.
Păi citește!
Domnul cunoaște calea celor drepți, dar calea celor răi va pieri.
Gata!
Să trăiți!
Tu știi ce citești?
Cred că este din Biblie, domnule.
Adu-i încoace.
I had memorized many psalms. Psalm 1 seemed as good a choice as any.
Sabina!
Richard!
Where is he hide?
Alice was there!
Be quiet, no talking.
Ia te uită! Faimoșii Richard și Sabina Urmbrand. Credeți că asta e o glumă? Reichul nu glumește. Sunteți acuzați de trădare împotriva statului și împotriva Führerului. Ce aveți de zis în apărarea voastră?
Nu suntem trădători. Suntem slujitorii Dumnezeului adevărat.
Veți fi judecați sub acuzația de trădare. Pedeapsa pentru această infracțiune este moartea prin împușcare de către plutonul de execuție. Du-i în celulă!
Pain. I'll not lie to you.
I'm sorry.
I'm thankful to be among the beaten through his grace and not among those who beat.
Cazul următor, 18.435, Richard și Sabina Wumbrand. Sunt acuzați de trădare împotriva statului prin organizarea de întâlniri secrete în rândul evreilor.
Cum pledați? Onorate instanțe, pot lua cuvântul?
Și dumneata cine ești?
Patrick Rutesfert, reprezentant diplomatic al Suediei. Tocmai am discutat cu mareșalul Antonescu. Domnia sa consideră că s-a făcut o greșeală.
Later we learned that we were only 1 hour from being executed. But God intervened. Along with some very dear friends.
Acuzație respinsă. Pauză o oră.
Nu uitați că oricine poate să greșească. Însă numai când ne căim, harul Domnului strălucește cu adevărat.
Under the Nazis, Richard was arrested 3 times. Myself 2. Each time we were beaten. And each time our friends intervened on our behalf. But the rest of my family was not so fortunate. There was no one to intervene for them. Were taken. And my sisters. My little brother. My uncle Jakob. All sent to the camp at Transnistria. None of them ever came back.
SS came looking for you today.
I'm not hiding.
Maybe you should. Couldn't you leave?
We want to meet them, to share Christ with them. Many are hungry to hear it.
And many more will send you to the gas chambers. One of them has just moved in with me.
Well, I hope you're offering him your best wine.
I knew him before, but he's changed. Now he's an absolute brute. He brags about how he killed Jews. He calls himself Borilla the Butcher.
Where?
Where what?
Where did he kill Jews?
Ukrainian border. Transnistria, I think.
Looking for Mihne?
Yes, I am. Richard Umbrandt.
Borila.
You live here now?
Not for long. Come on, Mihne's in the camp. Sounds German.
Das ist mir wurscht.
I knew it. You Germans should give me a medal. I kill more Jews than Rommel did.
I'm home because we're all out of Jews to kill. I am not afraid for those Jews. God will surely compensate them for what they've suffered. But I'm anguished when I think about what will happen to their murderers when they stand before God's judgment seat.
Murderers? Well, look who's here. Telling him your war stories, were you? Do you suppose half of them are true?
All of them are true. And many more you've never heard.
The more you drink, the more the story grows. Tell Richard what it was like to be stationed in the Soviet Ukraine. You enjoyed it, I gather.
Transnistria. The music, this is what I miss. The songs.
If you'd like to hear some of them, come over to my house. I'm no pianist, but I can play a few Ukrainian melodies.
I have something very important to tell you.
What? Go on.
If you were to look behind that door, you'd see my wife, Sabina. Parents, sisters, and her 12-year-old brother were killed with the rest of her family. You were there in Transnistria. That's where they were taken. You don't know exactly who you've shot, but we could assume you're the man who murdered her family.
You're a Jew.
I am a Christian.
Is this a trap?
No. Though I'm sure there are many who would like to kill you.
Let them try. I don't fear death.
You should fear God.
There is no God.
And what if I could prove to you there is?
You can't.
Let's do an experiment. I'm going to wake up my wife and tell her who you are and what you've done. And I can predict exactly what will happen.
I don't want an experiment.
She won't speak a word of reproach to you. In fact, she'll bring you the best supper she can find in this home.
I don't believe you.
There's a man here you have to meet. I believe he's the man who killed your family.
Forgive me. He can forgive you if he loves me.
What have I done?
That was when I started collecting these.
They remind me that the lost can be found.
Change your clothes. It's time to go. We can get you to the border if we leave now.
So that's your love story.
I guess it is. My love for a husband, my love for God, even my love for you.
Madam, I won't pretend I understand you. But perhaps if no one had this gift of returning good for evil, there would never be an end to killing.
If your enemy is hungry, give him bread. If your enemy is thirsty, give him some water.
You know this is ridiculous.
I suppose. I could not do such things. But Christ in me can do all things.
Tell me again, who told you about this family?
Just some guy.
Some guy? What guy? Before I get in this truck, I need to know who led you to this family.
I did. Get down before someone sees you.
From the day of my wedding forward, I only ever kissed two men. One, my husband, and two, the man who murdered my family.
Whatever, my Lord, thou hast taught.
say it is well, it is well with my soul.
Thank you, Scott. What a...
Though Satan should buffet, though trials should come.
Just so that you know, there's popcorn out there in the hallway. Take a bag when you leave, a couple, whatever. Thank you guys for coming tonight. I hope this was it was time well spent. Could we do that? I don't know, man. Christ is the only answer. I can't believe that that's what we have to do. You know, we may not love them. They may not be somebody that we like or love or anything like that, but God loves them, so we need to love them. So with that, we're going to close with prayer, and you guys be safe going home, and I really thank you guys for coming out tonight. Father God, we thank and praise you for this story that was told tonight, Lord. We pray that our hearts would be molded and made in that image, Lord, that we would be so willing and free to give your love to whomever you bring into our sphere, Lord, whether they're somebody that's lovable or not lovable, Lord. Let us... love them with your love. Let us share that with everyone that we come in contact with, Lord. And we'll praise and thank you for all that is accomplished. Lord, guide and direct us that we pray for our families and friends right now, Lord, that they would come to that grace, that they would come to that salvation soon, Lord. And we'll thank you and praise you for that. Because, Lord, we just see that the time ebbing on. And Lord, we want to make sure that... as many as we can find, as many as we can talk to, that they find a place in heaven through a relationship with you. Let them seek Jesus now while there's still time. We'll thank and praise you for that. Be with us as we travel home, Lord. Give us safety and bring us again when the doors are open, and we'll thank and praise you for that. In Jesus' name, amen.